to Twitch and make sure we are. Okay.
So, Ellen, wow. I learned about Twitch from my children.
I'm going to ask how you got to there.
So I learned about it from my children, and then, you know, all in like the same week, Candace is talking about it, and I'm like, what is this Twitch thing?
I've never heard that word before.
But I know I've seen a couple of people, I don't know where, Candace, did you post it somewhere or something? Someone said like they get a pretty decent amount of their income from Twitch. So
yeah, that my cousin is making money from Twitch, and so is my daughter's babysitter from when she was a kid. So there's income from it. I'm trying to figure out how to edit the stream. I can see the stream, but now I have to figure out how to edit it so I can tell them what I'm talking about. Podcast editing on Easter Sun. Oh no, this is it right here. So let me change it to.
So
primarily gamers on this.
There are primarily gamers. But there's also a lot of podcasters.
Oh, okay.
Aha, I can edit it.
So my children used to, well, my children are actually at the moment 17 and 12, and they've both been playing Minecraft for I don't know how many years. My
right.
son probably started playing Minecraft when he was about 4 or 5. And, they still play it, but they had this one YouTuber that they watched all the time, and his voice just really got on my nerves, but I'd let him watch it for so long. Then whenever me and Candace were talking about it, I was like, oh, okay, I know what you're talking about.
Okay.
So... yeah, my son streams on Twix, or whatever it's called. Twitch.
Twitch. Yeah.
Twitch. Yeah, he streams, and sometimes he's got hundreds of people watching him, which is kind of weird.
Yeah.
Interesting okay. to me.
There's the stream. It's working. Hi, everybody. If you'd like to follow us live, the link is in the chat or is in the description. It's momgeek.com/lunch. Okay. Twitch is live. So now let's go to our. Okay. And I've got it muted so you can't hear that. Do, do, do. Let me go back and find you guys. Oh, I can see you on Twitch. Actually, you know what? This actually might work out better for me because now I can see all of you. Well, we'll see what happens. All right. So you guys ready? Is everybody in? Let me find the Zoom link. Oh, we have Lisa in the waiting room. Christy, can I make you in charge of letting people in? Because obviously I didn't put a password on it.
Sure.
So I'm making you a co-host. All right. Good morning, Lisa. This is exciting. So how many of you have taken this particular class from me before?
I think I
nope.
have.
All right. I nope. have some truth bombs and an apology in the class. Here we go. I'm going to share my screen. Sharing my screen. This is exciting. And in case you missed it, we are live streaming on Twitch. Okay. I don't know how I'm going to handle all this, but I got Twitch, I got you guys, and I got the presentation. So we're going to do this. It's going to be so much fun. All right, let me make you guys bigger so I can see you. Oh, I like to see you guys. All right. Hi, everybody. So welcome to Identifying Your Ideal Client. This is our monthly Lunch and Learn where we talk about very important marketing topics. This one is, in my opinion, the most important topic. Because once you identify your ideal client, and we'll get into this in a minute, but once you identify your ideal client, when you say, yeah, your order will be $15,000, their answer is terrific. Right? So price becomes null and void when you know exactly who you're marketing to. And poo, where's my little button to forward to the next slide? No, Candace, you haven't been doing online classes for 5 years. It's been about 5 years, right? 4 years. Okay. Here we go. I found my button. Here we go. So everybody here knows me. I'm the host of the Be Who You Want to Be Business, Your Business, Your Life podcast. I'm a certified business coach. I've been in sales and marketing for since I was 18 years old. I'm an internet marketing pioneer, launched my first business in 1998. Award-winning speaker. I'm a Greener Still affiliate, and I'm a self-proclaimed gratitude geek. And I want you guys to introduce yourselves. So here's how introductions work. We're going to go in this order because this is the way I see you on my screen. Beverly, Ellen, Christy, Lisa, Beth. And the way it goes is, hi, my name is Candace. I live in Muskegon, Michigan, and I help micropreneurs create and implement realistic, executable marketing systems. So, Beverly.
Hi, my name is Beverly Stukas. I live in Norfolk, Massachusetts, and I help small businesses develop and maintain strong relationships with their clients.
Oh, you guys are getting good at this. Ellen.
Good morning, I'm Ellen. I live in Yucca Valley, California. And I also help small businesses retain and attain clients and develop relationships.
Nice. Christy?
And my name is Christy Going. I live near Houston, Texas. I offer creative ways for you to take your business relationships further using a variety of tools.
Excellent. And Beth?
Hello, I'm Beth. I live in Charleston, South Carolina, and I help travel agents remind their clients about things that need to be done, including passports, real IDs now, and much more. That's me.
Ding, 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 ding. That was the best one of all, you guys.
Thank you.
Pay attention to what Beth just did, and we'll talk about that as we go along. All right, we lost Lisa, but when she comes back, we'll have her introduce herself. Okay. Ooh. Hi there, Aldebar. Welcome. Okay, there's a guy on Twitch watching. It's my cousin. Hi. Okay. Wait, hold on. Hi. This is so much fun. All right. Now we're going to go into this QR code right here. So go ahead and do it now, or you can do it later. Just write it on a piece of paper. You aren't really going to need the worksheet, but you can download it later. That's so cute. There's a little bear on he put a little bear up. So you can download it now or download it later, but really unmute and ask questions during the class because interactive is best. This is a class. It's not a lecture. It's not a workshop. It's a class. So please let's be interactive. And I'll come that QR code will be up many times. So what are our objectives today? Why do you need a client avatar? What is a client avatar? And how do you create a client avatar? Now you notice that I answered the why before I put the why before the what, because I think that the why is kind of going to lay down the foundation of what we're doing here, and then we'll get into the what. So everybody has seen this before. You have all seen this before, and I hope you have a piece of paper because you're going to need it. It takes 5 to 12 contacts before someone is willing to give you money. 5 to 12, sorry. That's true for a streamer. That's true for a relationship marketer. That's true for a travel agent. That's true for a client manager, client account manager, an account manager. That's a good title. Account manager, Christy, I'm calling you that. All right. When you have your ideal client avatar created, you can cut that down to one contact or two, one or two. You can really cut down the amount of time that it takes for someone to be willing to give you money. Thank you, Aldebar. Aldebar is going to be lurking. That's good. Okay. So this is kind of fun. I'm having a good time. And that's kind of an important thing too, when you're in business, is that you have a good time. All right. So that's a foundation of why you need to know who your client avatar is. So on your piece of paper that you have, I would like you to list your last 3 to 10 clients first. Just list your last 3 to 10 clients. You don't have to share who they are. Just, I'll give you a minute. I should have some music playing. So list your, I wish I'd thought to put music out. I'll give you 60 seconds. Do it quickly. Okay. Now I want you to list your best 3 to 10 clients. Different line, different row. So one row is your last 10 clients and the next row is your best 10 clients. And it doesn't have to be 10. It can be 3 to 10, but at least 3. I have the best cousins. Have I told you that? Have I also mentioned that all my cousins are blonde? Okay, do we have a list? At least 3 in each column? Just for the record, I found my music. So now I have music if I need to do it again. This is my theme song for my podcast. Okay, there we go. So this is what I want you to do with the list.
Okay.
I want you to pick the 3, your 3 favorite from the list, and think about the PVP index. So the PVP index is, does this client bring me personal fulfillment? Does working with this client give me personal fulfillment? Can I provide this client value? Or you could also say, does this client bring me value? And do I make money with this client? Is there profit involved? So on a scale of 1 to 10, rate 3 of your clients on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 being nah and 10 being absolutely. You see what we're doing here? We're picking 3 and then we're rating them on a scale of 1 to 10 in these 3 areas. And after you've rated them each on a scale of 1 to 10, you add up their score. Ooh, music. It's like running a real hard race. I'm in the highest mountain to see all the world go. Looks like Beverly's still riding. Adds a little bit to it, doesn't it? Okay. Okay. So the client with the highest score is the closest to your ideal client avatar. So we're going to use them today to create our avatar. So does anybody have a surprise? Is anybody surprised by who they have, what the numbers turned out to be?
My ideal client's my best friend.
See? I love that. You know, my husband always says his only friends are his clients.
My best out of my numbers, my best friend is the one that gave me the best out of all my clients.
I love it. I love it. Okay, moving on. Okay, so what exactly is a client avatar? It's your buyer persona. It's your ideal client. It is the likes and wants of the person that buys the thing that you do. So most of you know, all of you know that my husband and I have owned a custom furniture business since 1998, right? And he's actually been making custom furniture since 1987. So when we joined forces in 98, we launched a website. And we targeted country gift shops because that was the type of furniture that he made. And back in 98, it was a much different life, world than it is now. And so things have evolved. But as time evolved, we learned that the people who purchase from us have a lot of things in common. They own two houses, all of them. There's never been a time where I can tell you, oh, they only own one house. And many of them own more than one house. All right. They collect antiques. They're usually retired or empty nesters. They drive some sort of electric car. I just said Tesla because I like Teslas. They retired young and they travel. All right. And the reason why they have two homes is because they like to spend time, you know, in one of the houses in their country home, and they like to spend time in the city, and they just want to get away. And sometimes they're, you know, that when you own two homes, you always have a vacation spot, right? So that is who we ended up selling to. So I targeted my messaging to Wendy, and everything that whenever I think about what am I going to say to these clients, Wendy is who I'm talking to. All right. Now, do every single one of our clients meet every single one of these checkpoints? No. But my message to that person is attractive. My message to Wendy is attractive to anybody who's going to buy from me. So that is what a client avatar is. So let's dig into how this is going to help you. So when you know who your client avatar is, what they do, where they live, when they shop, then you know how to reach them, right? So if you can answer those four questions, then you know how to reach them. And it could be that you're, and you also should know where to reach them. And you could be living in the wrong, you could be trying to reach them in the wrong place. So we're going to talk a little bit about that too, if we have time. Okay, so how do you create your client avatar? So here's where my truth bomb and my apology is. The last couple of times I taught this class, I used this avatar from Digital Marketer, this worksheet from Digital Marketer. The thing is, this worksheet and my avatar sheet look nothing like each other. This is too complicated. It's way too complicated. And shame on me, and I apologize for putting you through this horrible process. So let's do this. Let's make this kind of avatar because this is easier. She's got a picture. She's got a name. We know a little bit about her, right? So this isn't all I know about Wendy, but this is the important stuff. So how did I collect all this information on Wendy? Well, I answered some questions about her. So this QR code is the exact same QR code that I showed you earlier. So if you've already scanned it, you don't need it, but it takes you to the worksheet. So this is what I know about Wendy. I know what she has, I know what she wants, I know what she does, I know what she loves, and I know what she values. So loves are tangible and values are not tangible. So loves are things like people, places, things, and values are the guiding principles in her life. So let's break this down even further. So has. Let's think about your ideal client, the one that you had the highest score with, the highest PVV score, and let's start answering these questions about them. Where do they live? What kind of car do they drive? Like, okay, so best friend. Where does best friend live?
Down the street.
Say that 10 times fast. What kind of car does she drive? Where does she go on vacation? How many kids does she have? How old is she? And what is her gender? Answer that about your idea, about your best client. Oh, I really should have had the music playing. I'm sorry, guys. The next time I do this, I'm going to have music subtly playing in the background. Oh, there's Lisa. She's back. I'll let her in. Okay. We missed you, Lisa. At the end, we'll let you introduce yourself. Don't let me forget. Okay. Does everybody have their answers? Lisa, you'll get the replay so you can catch up. Do we need more time here? Do, 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 do. Well, you guys are thinking hard. Maybe I do have time to find some music. Look at those faces. Ellen's really studious.
Yeah, Ellen's having a hard time.
I think that Jeopardy music would be perfect.
Ooh, Susan. Yay.
What I did, Candace, was I pulled up my list of customers in send out cards.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know that about a lot of them. And the other thing is, the best people are those people who are on subscriptions, but they may be inactive. And as far as send out
cards. So think of the ones that send cards. Who sends the most cards? Okay. Hi, Susan. Don't worry, I have a replay, so you'll be able to catch up. Right now, we're thinking of what our best client has in terms of where they live, what kind of car they drive, where they go on vacation, how many children they have, their age, and their gender. So, Ellen, you can answer gender, and you can answer approximate age.
Yeah.
Let's see if I can get Susan's picture up. Yay!
Okay, well, I can answer car and where do they live.
Yeah, if you can answer just a few of the points, then that's a start. I want to see all of your faces. There we go. Okay. All right, so here, let's move on. So what do they do? What industry do they work in? Are they an employee or an entrepreneur? Do they volunteer? Do they have hobbies? Do they do any activities? And I know, but use your best guess. Like I knew that every single one of my clients collected antique furniture because the product that we made was beds that went with antique furniture. And again, you'll get the replay and all that good stuff. So you can come back and answer later. But let's really focus on that, your number one client right now. Or if you don't have a number one client, your ideal, what you know, who would you love to sell to? Like Pete's sake, I would love to sell to Jack Canfield. Oh my gosh, I'd love to make a bed for Jack Canfield. So what does he do? He's a professional speaker. See, an employee or an entrepreneur? He's an entrepreneur. Does he do volunteer work? Hell yeah, he does. He volunteers a lot of his time. What are his hobbies? No idea. What are his activities? He runs mastermind groups. I don't know, you know, but you can think of that. You can think of that too. You can use like a celebrity. Okay. So what do they want? So these are tangible things. And this is the one where your product, you have to really think about your product. So what do they want? If you're with Send Out Cards, which most of you are, or Greener Still, your clients want a way to talk to their clients. Your clients want their clients to buy more. They want them to buy more often, and they don't want to have to go chasing after new clients so much. They want to retain the old clients that they have. But what their answer to what do my ideal clients want could be more money, right? But what they really need is a way to retain them.
And more time.
And then how can you provide that service for them? What can you do for them? Okay. This is a hard one, but does anybody want to throw anything out there? Well, for Beth, she's a travel agent, right? Her ideal client wants a break. They want to go on vacation. They want, well, okay, so let's just, they want to go to Hawaii, right? They want to go to Hawaii. But what they really need is to get away from the office or get away from whatever's going on and just relax, right?
Correct.
Okay. So in the time of COVID, they want to go to Hawaii. Probably not a practical time to fly on an airplane for 10 hours. So, you know, you're in Florida. I'm sure the Virgin Islands are just, you know, a more practical escape, probably more cost effective. And you know, it can still give them that relaxing escape from reality that they're looking for.
Exactly. Oh, and then another good example is like the cruise industry. Can't cruise. So what us agents have been doing is we were turning our cruise vacationers into all-inclusive vacationers.
Exactly. Christy, did you have something you wanted to add?
Oh, I was just going to say that with my, with one of my services, not my products, but with my services, my ideal clients want to increase their sales and client retention. What they really need is more time. And how can I serve them? By offering my account management services and take care of the tools that they need while they focus on finding their ideal clients.
Exactly. Okay, so there's your tangibles. And this is where you can really dig deep and figure out who they are. And this is going to help you figure out where to market to. So what do they read? Where do they hang out? Who do they follow? What do they collect? And what do they covet? Right. What do they covet? So do you know what covet means? It means it's probably not a good word. But you know, it's something that they're envious of. It's something that they want, that, you know, feels a little bit intangible. However, something that if somebody covets something, we may have a solution to that, right? Let me think. Okay, a lot of folks coveted my husband's success as a furniture builder. And they would like steal his pictures and put them on their own website and try to say that they built it. I mean, they would do crazy things like that. All right. Well, if they had just reached out and asked, we could have helped them grow their own business. You know, we could have shown them how to do it without stealing our pictures. Okay, so that's loves. Now let's talk about the intangibles. The intangibles. These are the values. These are the guiding principles morality of a person. So do they value time management? Do they value money, which is kind of tangible, but wealth, I guess wealth. Do they value relationships? Do they value self-care? I'm thinking Beth. Do they value the environment, recycled paper? Do they value, you know, send out cards, greeting cards are printed on recycled paper. So if you value the environment, that is kind of a selling point for the cards. You guys look like you're really working hard. I love it. Okay.
Can I make one comment right here?
I'm sorry?
I'm going to make one comment right here. That second one right there, are they in alignment with my goals and values? That's like the number one reason that I work for myself. So that I can turn away those clients that are not in line with my values and goals. Because there's a lot of people out there that say they value something, but they don't necessarily value your time or your services or whatever. And to be able to identify that and tell them, yeah, I'm not the person for you, is really an actually like a great asset.
It is. That is. I'm starting to do that myself because my time is worth money and these people, especially in my business, they nickel and dime me to death. And I'm like, you want it or you don't. That's it. I'm not doing this.
Yeah. Yeah. So when you're looking at your list of clients, if your number one client is currently not in alignment with your goals and values, then you need It's going to sound controversial, but it's okay to keep doing business with them. Just don't market to them.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So if they want to give you money for the service or the product that you provide, great. But don't market to them. Market to the person that you want to do business with.
Right.
And that answers the question that I brought up about people who were on subscription but inactive.
Yeah.
Those are people that if they're not going to do the business, I don't need to market to them.
No. And you may do them a favor by just reaching out and saying, hey, you know, I noticed that you've had your account for a couple months and haven't been sending any cards. Can I help you with that?
Mm-hmm. Well, I have not a only that, but if you have people that are on there, like sometimes clearing out those, if they're on a subscription and they're not using it, a lot of times those people will appreciate it if you reach out to them and say, hey, you know, I noticed that you're not using your subscription. You know that you can become a basic client for just this. And then you're also, that way you're also clearing out the people that are not in line with what you're, to open the door for people who are in line with what you're doing to come in.
Good idea. Yeah.
Well, and some of the clients that are, I mean, some of you may not have been around when we had points, but I still have clients that are on points. And they like the points because they can just send their Christmas cards. But what they don't know is that they're probably spending too much on them right now. So right now is a good time to reach out to them and say, hey, you know, we have these new plans and you're probably spending too much on the cards that you send. Or, you know, you don't have to have this account. You can have the free account. And then when you're ready to send cards, you just pay for them as you send them. So, but that's kind of not in the alignment thing. The alignment thing is, you know, if there's someone on your list that is in alignment with your goals and values, how can you do more business with them? How can you, and maybe it could be that you might think that you have a certain list of goals and values, but you don't really. If you're not attracting people who are in alignment with you, you might not really have those goals and values that you think you have. As there's a truth
bomb there. Or it could be the law of attraction.
Yeah.
And you're focusing on the things that you don't want. So you're attracting more of that to you.
Mm-hmm.
Been there, done that.
That's true too. That's true too. So do we have questions on this? Any more comments? Okay. So this is probably the most important key, the most important box in the worksheet, but it's the hardest one to it might be the easiest one. I mean, I know that if you want to be in alignment with my values, you care about the environment, you care about value, about quality and value. I'm thinking about my custom furniture business. You know, you don't want to buy something every 5 years and then throw it away. You want to buy something that lasts a lifetime. I really like doing business with people who give a lot of their time to charities, you know, and a lot of my clients actually run their own charities. So that's important to me too. Hey, Lisa. So don't worry, the replay will have everything in it. So don't feel like you haven't caught up. Okay. So, you know, the values thing, it's the hardest, but it's also the easiest. What's really hard is when you look at your client list and they don't match up. That's when you have to think, oh, because I have a very good client for my furniture business, a very, very good client. And first glance, I'm like, oh, I can't believe we're doing business with them because of what he does for a living. But then I think about, oh, well, they own this farm and they bring inner city kids to the farm and they teach them about farming. So they give these inner city kids an opportunity to go out in the country that may not have even seen a live cow in their life, and they can milk cows. So does the for the company that he is the CEO of, is that outweighed by the charitable work that they do? It is.
Yeah.
It is to me.
It is.
So And also, you know, just because he's the CEO of that company, that, you know, it's one of those evil empire companies, just because he's the CEO of that company doesn't mean that he is evil. It just means that the choices that the board of directors have made, you know, have gone astray. And however, going forward, are they changing? Probably. So, you know, it's just, but yeah, I just have to remember that there's, you just, the goals and values thing is, it's a tough one, but, okay. So we've dug into that deeply. Now let's actually create your client avatar. So remember mine looks like, hold on, do I have a picture of it next in the next slide? No. So mine looks like this. I should have grabbed another one. Mine looks like this. It's really simple. I have her name. Catching up. I have her name. I have a little bit about her and a picture of her, right? Very simple. So, but I've answered here, so I don't make everybody seasick. Let's do this. But I've answered all these questions before I created that little graphic. So I found a photograph of somebody who looks the way I think that Wendy would look. I gave her a name. I've figured out her age and gender. Age is, you know, she's empty nester. So that isn't really an age, but she's in her 60s, right? You know, I know what she used to do. She used to work for an NGO or a nonprofit. I know where she lives. She lives in New York or Houston, never Houston, LA, San Francisco, Seattle, right? She lives in one of those cities. And I'm not saying never Houston because that's not where I want them to be. It's because none of my clients have ever been from Houston, even though I lived there. None of these clients have ever been from Houston, even though I lived there for 20 years and we ran our business there. Most of them were from New York, LA, Seattle, Florida. The ones in Florida, they're retired, right? So how many children do they have? Well, I know all their kids are grown up. They're empty nest, you know, because they're empty nesters. And there might be two or three of them, maybe one, you know, one to three kids, all grown up. Doesn't really matter. They have grandkids, right? And I know that they live in a city, but they also have a house in the country. I know that they, you know, I know that they make $200,000 to $300,000 a year still, even though they're retired. And they probably have graduate degrees. And I know that they collect antiques. So that's mine. I mean, that's mine. So that's how I created Wendy. I could answer these questions. So take your best customer. Let's just call him Charlie. Right? Let's put Charlie's name down on a piece of paper. Charlie is, I'm making this up. All right. Charlie's 75 years old. He's a man. He's a plumber. He has four kids. He's in Yucca Valley. he always says excellent. I don't know. He's a plumber. He's a, I have occupation on there twice. He owns the plumbing company. They probably do $300,000, $400,000 a year. They've got a couple people who work for him. He just went to plumbing school. He doesn't, you know, he never got a upper level degree. He just went to plumbing school. He likes to tinker around in his garage. He likes to mow his lawn. And he loves going to baseball games. All right. That's Charlie. Totally just made him up. But he lives in Yucca Valley and he's a plumber.
His name is Mike.
His name is Mike. Okay, there. So you guys, can you see how you can do that with your best client that you have right now, that you can just do this?
Yeah.
And then go back to the values and tweak it a little bit to up your game. So Beth, it's her best friend, but, you know, tweak it a little bit so that you can attract more than just your best friend as your client, but use her as your ideal, you know, your avatar. Oh my gosh, it is 12:42 already, people. We got a lot done. All right.
No.
So all of this will be in the replay, and the replay will be available as soon as I figure out how to get it off of Twitch. Okay. So here are the four ways that I can continue to help you coaching with coaching every Thursday. Most of you know about Marketing Toolbox training. It's 10:30 on Thursdays Eastern time. These lunch and learns are the first Wednesday of the month. And the next one is going to be, no, I forgot. No, I can't remember. I'll remember before I tell you. And then Coffee Club is group coaching. It's twice a month. It's on the second and fourth Wednesday. It's a pay what feels good business model. So it starts at $7, goes up to $250. You pick the range that feels good to you. And then you get group coaching twice a month, plus a little bit extra. And then one-on-one coaching, you can hire me to help you for 6 weeks, 3 months, or a year, and I'll work alongside you to reach your goals. So those are the four ways that I help you as a coach. Here's your QR code again so that you can download that worksheet and the replay of the video and schedule a 20-minute marketing consultation with me. So if you haven't hovered over the QR code, just take your phone, put it in QLens and hover over it, and it will open up for you. And here's my contact information. Different QR code. This is how you can connect with me on all the social media and all that good stuff. All right, questions. Do we have questions? Can I stop sharing my screen? Yes, all right. Questions.
Don't forget.
What do you wish? Go ahead.
Introduce themselves.
Oh, yes, Susan and Lisa, go ahead and introduce yourselves. So Lisa, you're first.
Hello, I'm Lisa Roof, and I am with Send Out Cards as well as another company, Pharmanex. And I just love coming and popping in and when I can. It's been a little crazy, but I'm really excited to be able to pop in today and see as much as I can.
Excellent. And Susan, introduce yourself. Oh, she might not. I don't think she has sound. Yeah, she doesn't have sound. Susan is a wonderful woman. Shane and I were talking about you the other day. She's a wonderful woman that lives in New Jersey, but I met her when she lived in Conroe, Texas. She and her husband had a hot dog cart. So I love Susan. She's fabulous. Okay. So no more questions? What would you like me to teach next month? What do you want to know more about? Go ahead, Beverly.
I was just going to ask a question about this. Like, does it ever make sense to have more than one idea?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Okay. All right. Because I can see several different models for, you know, putting all that together several different ways for send out cards.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. But when you're doing your marketing message, oh, I know what next month is going to be. It's where to market. Let me write that down. Because your clients might not be where you hang out. You know, and if you look at them, if you go through the whole thing, oh, this is my ideal client. Well, I'm hanging out on a Twitter. Mm-hmm. I never see them on Twitter. I never see, like, it because let's just use best friend. We're going to call her Sally. Sally, Beth hangs out on Twitter, but Sally doesn't hang out on Twitter. Well, Sally is best customer. So where does Sally hang out? Does she even hang out on social media?
Right.
You know? Yeah, I don't hang out in Facebook. So if you want me to be your best customer, that's not where you're going to find me. You know? Okay. So we're going to wrap up because 12:45 is the end time, unless there's questions. I expect to see your client avatars in the next couple of weeks. Don't just let this sit around in your head. Take action on it. Put it to work. Because when you know, like I said, when you know who your best customer is and you say your order is going to be $15,000, they say excellent, right? They say excellent. That massage, yeah. I'm just using massage. That massage is going to be $200 today. Excellent. It's going to cost you $1,000 to send out those cards. Excellent. You know, your vacation to the Virgin Islands is going to be $1,200 a person. Is that about right? I don't know. $1,500 a person, all inclusive for 3 days. Excellent. You know, I'm just guessing. I haven't been to the Virgin Islands. I don't know.
You're fine.
And the thing is with all inclusives, there are all inclusives right here on the mainland. You don't have to travel very far. Okay, so we will see you tomorrow for toolbox training, or the first Wednesday in April for the next lunch and learn. But in the meantime, get your client avatars done and send them to me. I want to see them.
And where will the replay be on your web?
That QR code. Mm-hmm. We'll have the replay.
Oh, the QR. That's right. You said that.
Mm-hmm. So it'll be in the QR code.
Okay.
As soon as I figure out how to get it off of Twitch. Thank you for helping me experiment with live streaming on Twitch today. I appreciate it. Thank you, Twitch people, for watching. All right. We'll see you guys later. Take care.
Bye.
Bye.